Take a look at that. We made that.
Yes, we did.
Yeah, with a little bit of help from Chef Gretchen Hanson of Rehoboth Beach. And Jimmy is eating his already.
I was supposed to leave that for a pretty
this
shot.
This is our pumpkin crab bisque.
That's
oh,
your
my goodness.
Yes, it is. And that's actually made with sweet dumpling winter squash, as well as my favorite, which is kombucha, which is this little ugly thing right here.
Yeah.
So that's a kombucha. And this is a sweet dumpling. And the thing I love about the sweet dumpling is that it has such a sweet flavor. It's like honey.
This is fantastic.
Yeah, really named appropriately.
So we are going to now make a pumpkin butter. And what we're going to use is a true pumpkin pie pumpkin.
Okay.
So if you see over here, I've got all the different types of winter squashes and minus a few, which I just couldn't find, that you can use. But different ones have different functions and different purposes. So this is the true pumpkin pie pumpkin. If you notice, it's a lot smaller than the one you carve.
And this one's already baked?
Right, this one's already baked. So again, you throw it in an oven 350 whole, and then you're just gonna take the top, you're gonna go like this, boo-boo, and then you're going to scoop the seeds out onto your thing right here. I'm gonna throw the butter in here. Jimmy, you're gonna take a little spoonful of your pumpkin pie spice and throw that in there. I'm gonna turn up this heat a little bit.
In there with the butter?
Sure.
Seriously, a spoonful or just?
No, I mean, 'cause I got a big spoon like a teaspoon or two. Yeah, that's about a teaspoon and a half. So just throw that in there.
All right.
And what we want to do is to let that fragrance come out of the spices. So you've got to heat up your spices for the fragrances to come out of them. So it releases the aromatherapy oils, the aromatic oils, et cetera,
and that's half of enjoying all
of this. Yes, it is. And I'm unfortunately, I'm like very, very congested right now, so I can't smell a thing, which
we'll
is making me really sad. So if you can get those little green bits out of there.
Oh, I put in some extra, didn't I?
You did
Sorry
put
about
in some
that.
Extra. You don't want the green bits because they are non-edible. Now, certain squashes do have edible crusts or edible skins. One of the things you want to make sure of when you do buy a squash is you want to make sure that it's been hardened off for winter. And the way you can tell is by seeing that little stem, how woody it is. That means it's been hardened off. And actually, I got one at the grocery store that wasn't properly hardened off.
Right.
And you can see how the stem is still green. All the rest of these are from the farmer's market. But you can see here, the stem is still green. It's got a lot of orange on it. This is an acorn squash. And it's shiny.
Right.
Okay, see how shiny
that is? So this one's the right one, this one's not.
Well, okay, remember they're different squashes, okay? But remember that this is a shiny stem, this has a shiny coat, and this is a woody stem with a matte coat. So what you're really looking for is the matte, and they really should be matted.
Okay.
You know, like have that sort of dull gloss to them.
Gotcha.
And all different ones. Now, people always ask, sorry to come around the other side, people always ask me, what is the difference between a yam, and this is a yam, and a sweet potato? And this is a white sweet potato that we made the sweet potato latkes out of. Well, they're absolutely not the same thing at all, because yams are not really sweet, and they're highly fibrous, and they're very, very starchy. So if you're going to be doing cooking for winter squashes, you want a sweet potato, either a red or a white one, a garnet or a Beauregard. That's what you want to get, not the yam.
Listen,
now, how are you doing over there? Scoop that into
this
that butter.
Okay, you want this all in the
butter? Yeah, scoop it into the butter.
You
now, I'm going to jump the gun over here because I'm going to dump a little bit of brown sugar in here. I'm going to go throw a smidge of maple syrup.
Keep doing what you're doing. I'm going to tell them how to get your recipe.
Okay.
If you want the recipe, all you have to do is send us a self-addressed stamped envelope, 1729 North Salisbury Boulevard in Salisbury. That's 21801. You'll also find the recipe on our website, DelmarvaLife.com. All you have to do is click on What's Happening Today.
And
I'm
if
running
you
out
want
of time.
All the recipes, you can go to www.chefgretchenhanson.com, and they'll all be right there. There's going to be about 20 pumpkin recipes. Little bit of vanilla, little bit of maple syrup, little bit of brown sugar, a little bit of Grand Marnier. I'm gonna throw a little bit more pumpkin in here. We're gonna cook it, and I want you guys to taste this before we lose our time.
Well,
so these are pumpkin ginger snaps with pumpkin butter, and this has had a vanilla pudding added to it. And this is the straight pumpkin butter, so I'm gonna give one of you that one. Notice how he took the sugar one.
Well,
And then you take the white sweet potato latkes, and then you're gonna have to swap.
All right.
So this is the straight pumpkin butter with the sweet potato latkes.
Oh, that is good.
Isn't that yummy?
That is very yummy.
The pumpkin butter's delicious, and it keeps for a long time in the refrigerator, or you can freeze it, and you can have it all winter long.
Gretchen, thank you so much.
You are so welcome.
We have so much here. It's all gonna be on our website.